Hello everybody, my name's Walter, and today I want to show you my hidden armor dispenser. You can see here in front of you. As you can see, I have a little floor here, and if I stand in the middle of this floor, and then press this button, as you can see, at the moment I'm not wearing any armor, but now I'm fully armored. And that's basically what this little contraption here does. It well dispenses a full set of armor for well, if you need it. Okay, so now you know what it does. Now let's go and show you what resources you need. So if you want to build it, you need some normal building blocks, 9 obsidian blocks, 5 slime blocks, 3 redstone wire, 2 redstone repeaters, 2 sticky pistons and 4 dispensers. For the control circuit here with the button, I used an button of course, then an additional redstone dust, 1 torch and 1 repeater. And of course you need some armor you put into the dispensers. Now, how big is this whole circuit? As you can see here, it's 4x4 with a height of 5 blocks. Just one little thing I want to mention. This sticky piston here gets pushed down 1 block more, 1 block further, so you shouldn't put something immovable down here, or anything for this matter. Okay, now that you know what you need and how much space you need, let's start with the building. So the first thing you have to do is of course deciding where you want your hidden armor dispenser to be. In this case I want it to be flush with this floor here, and the position is where those 2x2 blocks are. Okay, so now go below one of those corners here, leave one high gap and place a normal block. Put some redstone on top of it, and then you can place 4 dispensers around like this, as you can see here. Now grab some obsidian, place 2 like this, and another 3 like this. Grab 2 repeaters, 1 here, 1 here, come on. This one here you put on 4 ticks, this one 2 ticks. Finally put some redstone down here, put a normal block down here, some redstone on top of it. Now grab a sticky piston, place it facing upwards here, and another one down here. Grab your slime blocks and place them in a 2x2 platform, and another block down here. Finally put some blocks on top of the slime blocks, and to top it off, and close this space here with some obsidian. Okay, now last thing to do is actually hooking this up with a button. For this you have just to power this block here. In this case I'm using a repeater that's taking an output from the torch, then some redstone on top of this block here, and finally the block with the button. And as you can see, if the button gets activated, the floor retracts, and as soon as the button deactivates, the dispensers work and the floor closes again, as you can see. Last thing to do is filling in the dispensers. And done! As you can see, I filled in the dispensers, and if I now stand in the middle of the 2x2 platform here and press the button, you can see I get armored again. Okay, So, now there are two little modifications you can do with this design here. Since the dispensers are open on one side, you have access to them, which means that you can place a refilling system here. For example, with some chests here, which gives you a lot more space for armor, so you can use this armory or this hidden armor dispenser a lot more times than you would normally. And finally, you can, this could be interesting for those of you who want to build challenge maps. If you put blocks besides the dispensers and power them, you can deactivate the dispenser without deactivating the other dispensers. So in this case, now the leggings aren't dispensed. So just to show you, as you can see, I have a chestplate, a helmet and boots, but no leggings, since they are deactivated. Of course, if you want to deactivate this dispenser here, you would have to reposition the button and the control circuit here. But nevertheless, that's how you can modify this basic structure here. Okay, so now that was how you can build my hidden armor dispenser. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!